He may not have won American Idol, but this singer sure knows how to entertain. Welcome to WatchMojo.com, and today we're taking a look at the life and career of Adam Lambert. Adam Mitchell Lambert was born January 29, 1982, and raised in San Diego, California. When he was 9, he began appearing in local theatrical productions and soon started vocal lessons. He consequently fell in love with the stage and the art of performing, so he continued to act and sing while attending high school. After a few weeks at college, Lambert dropped out to pursue a career in entertainment. He relocated to Los Angeles and landed roles in a few musicals. His first major production was 2004's The Ten Commandments, the musical, where he played Joshua alongside Val Kilmer's Moses. Lambert also toured with the production of Wicked and was hired as a studio singer during this period. His big break came along in 2009 after he auditioned to be a contestant on the 8th season of the reality television program American Idol.
Mama, life has just begun, but now I've gone and thrown it all away.
Okay.
During the singing competition's 4-month run, Lambert advanced through the rounds thanks to the judges' praise and audience votes. His vocal range and enthusiasm for performing in a theatrical style kept him safe week after week, and even garnered him standing ovations. Some of Lambert's most notable performances included his renditions of songs like Black or White, The Tracks of My Tears, Mad World, and If I Can't Have You. During the final, he found himself facing off against contestant Chris Allen. He also got the chance to sing We Are the Champions with Queen members Brian May and Roger Taylor. Though he was ultimately named runner-up, Lambert was quickly signed to RCA Records. Just because his time on American Idol was over didn't mean he was out of the media spotlight. After he admitted to being gay in Rolling Stone magazine, he reunited with some of his castmates on the successful American Idol's live tour that summer. His solo debut dropped in November. For Your Entertainment blended genres such as pop, rock, and dance, and opened at third place on the Billboard 200 chart. Lambert co-wrote some of the tracks, and worked with artists like Lady Gaga, Pink, and Weezer's Rivers Cuomo on others. The album was mostly well-received and included his first top 10 single, the Grammy-nominated What Do You Want From Me?
Hey, slow it down. What do you want from me? What do you want from me?
Lambert also promoted the record with a sexually suggestive and controversy-generating performance of the title cut during the American Music Awards that same year. Next, the singer showed off his dramatic vocal abilities and stage presence on the Glam Nation tour. Following the positively reviewed acoustic live EP, Lambert's contagious live energy and musical talent were captured and released on the 2011 CD-DVD Glam Nation Live. During this period, he made a number of television appearances, including returning to American Idol and serving as guest judge on the fashion reality show Project Runway. Lambert also performed once again with members of Queen during the MTV Europe Music Awards. 2012 saw the release of Lambert's sophomore effort, Trespassing. He once again worked with different artists and producers on the album and promoted it with several television appearances and live gigs. The disc's lead single was the electropop tune Better Than I Know Myself.
If I wanted to leave, I would have left by now, but you're the only one that knows me.
It was also announced that Lambert would reunite with Queen for select performances later that year. In addition to music, Lambert has helped raise money for various charities and is a passionate advocate of equal rights for the LGBT community.
It's so phallic.
His powerful and versatile voice, combined with over-the-top performances, have won over Glamberts around the world. And though he has been influenced by many, Adam Lambert is now most definitely a thriving artist in his own right.
Let me out of the street.